Hello everyone again, welcome back to our online class. How are you today? I believe you are fine. Why? I know that because yesterday was a holiday, so you can relax, right? You didn't study. So I'm sure that you are fine now. So yesterday was Wednesday, we didn't study because it was a holiday, and today is Thursday, and on Thursday we always study about what book? You're right, Bright One, right? Okay, so I hope you have this book all together. So on Monday and Tuesday, we always study about Blueprint 2, right? And Wednesday and Thursday, we study about Writing Bright 1. And on Friday, we study about Speaking to Tell 1B, right? So I hope you have these three books all together. So before going to our lesson today, can I ask you what did we learn on Tuesday? So Tuesday, we learned about Blueprint 2, right? Okay, I hope you remember something from that lesson, from that day, from that video that I taught you on Tuesday. So now it is Thursday and we have to go to our Writing Bright 1, right? So can you open your book on page 61? So today we are going to do exercise on page 61, 62 and 63. A lot, right? It's not a lot, why? Because yesterday we didn't study, so today we have to do a lot of exercises. Remember, the more you do, the better you will be, right? If you don't do exercise, how can you remember the lesson, right? Okay, so now let's go to the exercise. Okay, so here we have exercise number 3, exercise number 4, and exercise number 5, right? So let's go to each one all together. So let's go to exercise number 3. So like I told you, before you do exercise, you have to read the instruction, right? Read the instruction. Here we call the instruction. In each exercise, if you don't read the instruction, you might possibly do it in the wrong way. For example, the instruction, they ask you to circle the correct answer, and then you see A, B, C, D, you circle, and then you see the blank, you circle, and then you write. So if you are my student, you will be wrong, I will give you 0. Why? Because the instruction, I ask you to circle, not to write. Okay, so it is very important that you have to read the instruction before you do the exercise. One more example, T for true, F for false. I'm sure you have done a lot of exercise about that, right? So when they ask you to write T, you just write little t, don't write true. If they ask you to write F, just write F, don't write false. Okay, if they ask you to write true, don't write T. If they ask you to write false, don't write F. Okay, they ask you to write A, you write A. Circle, you have to circle. Underline, you have to underline. That's why I told you, you have to read the instruction carefully before you do the exercise. Some exercises you did very, 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 very well, correct all, but you didn't follow the instruction. So it is wrong, okay? So here, this is, we call the instruction. So complete the sentences using the words in the box. Put none if no words is needed. So we have number 1, number 2, and number 3. But before going to each number, I would like you to read this instruction again. Complete the sentences using the words in the box. So here, if you speak slow, it will be what? It will be sentences, right? Sentences. But if you speak fast, it will be sentences. But one more way, if you are an American speaker, I mean people who speak American English, they will read sentences. It seems like letter T is omitted. They don't pronounce letter T. So the American people, they don't pronounce sentences. They pronounce sentences. But both are correct. You can say sentences or sentences. Both are correct. Okay. So British complete the sentences, but American complete their sentences. Okay. But both are correct. But if you want to speak sentences, you have to speak fast. You cannot say complete the sentences. No, complete the sentences. Okay. But if you speak slow, you can pronounce T. Complete the sentences. Okay. So the instruction, complete the sentences using the words in the box. Put none, N-O-N-E, if no words is needed. So let's go to number 1. So number 1, there are two, right? Two words or two phrases in the box. So a bike and then a toolbox. So let's go to each one all together. So Alex wanted to ride. Ride what? Ride a bike or ride a toolbox? What is it? You are right. Ride a bike. So Alex wanted to ride a bike, but his new bike was broken. He cried blah 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 a lot. So he cried a bike a lot. he cry a toolbox a lot, or he cry a lot with just none. It means that we don't need to complete. So the answer is none, right? So here, he cry a lot, we don't need these two words into that blank, so you have to put none. Okay, continue. His father brought blah 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 and fixed the bike quickly. So here, his father brought a bike, or his father brought a toolbox, or his brother brought and then fixed the bike quickly. So the answer is a toolbox, right? So his father brought a toolbox and fixed the bike quickly. Let's continue. Now Alex is lasting blah 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 again. So lasting a bike again, lasting a toolbox again, or lasting again. You're right, lasting again. We don't need any word. Okay, now let's read again. Alex wanted to ride a bike, but his new bike was broken. Okay, he cried a lot. His father brought a toolbox and fixed the bike quickly. Now Alex is lasting again. Okay, let's go to number two. So number two, there are three phrases. So number one is very mysterious. Number two, a heavy box and the police. You know, very mysterious. Mysterious refer to something that is strange, that is not known, that is not to be understood. Something that is something that you don't know, we call mysterious. A heavy box. Heavy is the opposite word of light, right? Oh, so heavy. And then this marker is so light. Okay, heavy, light. The police, you know, the police, right? So let's go. Jim was walking blah 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 along the river. Jim was walking along the river. So what is the answer? Jim was walking, very mysterious, a heavy box, or the police? So Jim was walking along the river, right? It is none. We don't need to add any word. Let's continue. He found blah 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 near the river. He found very mysterious. He found a heavy box, or he found the police near the river. So the answer is yeah, a heavy box. So he found a heavy box near the river. It looked blah blah blah. It looked very mysterious, or it looked the police. You're right. It looked very mysterious, very strange. It looked very mysterious. He called the police, right? He called the police and they took the box. So they had referred to the police, right? Okay, now we finished number two, but let's read again. So Jim was walking along the river. He found a heavy box near the river. It looked very mysterious. He called the police and they took the box. Okay, now we finished exercise number one and number two. So let's go to number three. So there are two phrases: a beautiful rose garden and many kinds of roses. Okay, so let's go. My grandma planted blah blah blah. So planted what? Planted a beautiful rose garden, or planted many kinds of roses? Yeah, planted many kinds of roses. Okay, so the grandmother planted many kinds of roses. You know, plant, right? Plant flowers, plant tree. Okay, continue. The roses grew blah 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 very quickly. So we don't need, right? So it is none. The roses grew very quickly. Our garden turned into what? Into a beautiful rose garden. Okay, so now let's read number three again. My grandma planted many kinds of roses. The roses grew very quickly. Our garden turned into a beautiful rose garden. Okay, so now we have finished our big exercise number three. Let's go to number four. So number four, like I told you, you have to read the instruction first. Number four, complete the sentences using like, or into, or none. So here there are 10 sentences, right, from number one to number 10. And there are also 10 blanks, or probably more than 10 blanks. So in each blank, you have to complete with the word like, or the word into, or some blank you don't need to complete anything, like this one here, none, right? Okay, so let's go to number one. Number one, can you read? Okay, so learning to ski sounds blah 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 a great idea. Sounds a great idea. Sound like, sounds into, or sound a great idea? You're right, sounds like. So learning to ski sounds like a great idea. It sounds blah 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 interesting. So it sounds like interesting, it sounds into interesting, or it sounds interesting. Yeah, it sounds interesting. So we don't need to add anything, right? So let's go to number two. I feel blah blah lonely. I feel lonely. I feel like lonely. I feel into lonely, or I feel lonely. Okay, I feel lonely, right? So we don't need to complete anything. I feel like a stranger. You know, stranger is a person that you don't know. Okay, when you go to somewhere and then you see a person that you don't know, he is the stranger. Okay, you don't know. Okay, so now we have finished number one to number two. Let's go to number three. So number three, it smells blah 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 popcorn. It smells good. It smells like, it smells into, or it smells popcorn. You're right, it smells like. Let's go to number four. The leaves turn yellow and orange. You know leaves, right? The leaves of the tree, right? Okay, the leaves turn yellow and orange. So what is your answer? Turn like, turn into, or turn yellow and orange? Here we read orange, not orange. Okay, orange. So the leaves turn yellow and orange. We don't need anything here. Let's go to number five. The small town turned blah, blah blah a large city. You know, large means big, right? So the small town turned like a large city, or turned into a large city, or turned a large city. So the answer is turn into, right? Why? Because first of all, it is a small town, and then it turned into a very large city. Okay, let's go to number six. John was very angry. You know, angry, right? Furious. His face turned like red, turned into red, or turned red? You're right, turn red. Let's go to number seven. Here we did seven. Seven, not so when, okay? Not so when. Seven. My basement turned blah 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 a music studio. You know basement? Basement is a room underground. It's an underground room. So most of the houses in European countries or in America, they always have a basement. So sometimes basement is a place that they keep things, but we can live there. Okay, so my basement turned blah 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 a music studio. So turn like, turn into, or turn a music studio? You're right, turn into, right? Why turn into? Because first of all, it is a basement, but now it turned into a music studio. Let's go to number eight. His hair turned white overnight. Turn what? Turn white, right? We don't need anything. So when we talk about color, turn yellow and orange, turn red, turn white. Let's go to number nine. The small tree grew tall. Grew like tall, grew into tall, or grew tall? Grew tall, right? We don't need anything here. Number 10. The tadpole grew a frog. Grew, you know, tadpole. So if you were born in a countryside, if you were born in a farmer family like me, I was born in a countryside. My house was surrounded by a lot of farms. So I know tadpole. Tadpole is they are mostly black. So when they grow up, they become a frog. So tadpole grew into, right? First of all, it is a tadpole, now it becomes a frog. Okay, so now we finish exercise four, but we have to read again. So number one, learning to ski sounds like a great idea. It sounds interesting. So like I told you, interesting, right? Number two, I feel lonely. I feel like a stranger. Stranger is a person that you don't know. Number three, it smells like popcorn. It smells good. Number four, the leaves turn yellow and orange. Number five, the small town turned into a large city. Number six, John was angry. His face turned red. Number seven, my basement turned into a music studio. Number eight, his hair turned white overnight. Number nine, the small tree grew tall, right? And number 10, the tadpole grew into a frog. Okay, so now we have finished exercise four. Let's go to our last exercise, number five. Complete these incomplete sentences using a proper verb, a proper object, or a proper subject complement. So what does mean subject complement? You studied already, right? So subject complement will refer to a noun or an adjective that comes after a linking verb, and it describes the subject, right? So here there are five sentences. These sentences are incorrect, or we can say are incomplete. They need something. Some sentences, they need a verb. Some sentences, they need an object. Some sentences, they need a subject complement. So what we need to do is we have to read these sentences one by one clearly to find out whether it needs a verb, it needs an object, or it needs a subject complement, right? So let's go to number one. Laura classical music. Laura classical music. So this is the subject, this is the object. So what do we need? We need a verb, right? So you can say Laura likes classical music. Laura loves classical music. Laura hates classical music. So the answer can be various, can be different, right? So actually you have to write the sentences again, but now I don't want to write it. We just add here, right? So we add one verb. So Laura loves, example here. So Laura loves classical music. Okay, let's go to number two. He a sports car. He a sports car. So he is a subject, a sport car is an object. So what do we need? We need a verb, right? Like sentence number one, two. So you can say he likes a sports car, he loves a sport car, he wants a sport car, he needs a sport car, he buys a sport car, he watches a sports car. So there are a lot of answers, right? So you have to add one verb here. So I add he drives. Okay, don't forget S, right? Understand? Let's go to number three. They hot tea at the cafeteria. So they hot tea at the cafeteria. So they subject here, object, right? So we need verb again. So they what? They drink, right? So here they drink. But in the exercise you have to write the full sentence again, but here because I don't have enough space, so I just add, right? But in your exercises you have to write the new sentence. For example, Laura loves classical music. Number two, he drives a sports car. Number three, they drink hot tea at the cafeteria. Okay, let's go to number four. The children ice cream. The children ice cream. So now we need a verb again, right? So the children eat, right? Eat ice cream. So here this is a plural, right? Child, children. So child, singular, right? Child. I have one child. Okay, but when it is plural, children, not children. Okay, child, singular, children, plural. Child, children. Child, children. Okay, let's go to number five. Susan bought at the supermarket. Susan bought at the supermarket. So now we have Susan is a subject, bought is a verb, and where is the object? We don't have, right? Or subject complements, right? So bought what? Bought a phone, example. Bought a phone, bought a key, bought a camera, bought an underwear. So bought a phone, right? So now we know Susan bought a phone at the supermarket. Okay, so these are the five sentences of exercise five, and there are five more sentences that you should do. So now please open your book on page 62 altogether. So open your book on page 62. So here, exercise number five. Here, this is exercise number five, but I already corrected five sentences already. There are five more sentences and they are your homework, so you have to do it, right? So your homework, you have exercise number from number 6 to number 10, and then you also do exercise 6. So exercise 6, correct the underlying mistakes, very easy, right? And then number 7, find the mistakes and correct them, focus on the verbs. So exercise number 6, exercise number 7, and these 5 sentences in exercise number 5, they are all your homework. And also go to page 63. So page 63, here we have three exercises A, B, C, and you have to do it all. They are all your homework. So your homework, 5 sentences here, exercise number 6, exercise number 7, and A, B, C on page 63. You have to do it all, and you have to submit to your teacher. Remember, the more you do, the cleverer you will be, right? If you don't know, if you feel lazy, how can you become an outstanding student? Remember, your parents pay a lot of money for school. They try to find money, they try to earn money for you to study. If you don't study, you will make them feel disappointed, right? So please try to study. The more homework your teacher give to you, the more they love you, because they want you to become a better student, an outstanding student, right? So please do it. So these are your homework on page 62 and page 63. And please do it and submit to your teacher, and your teacher will give feedback, okay? So that's all of our lesson today, and I hope to see you again soon. Goodbye.